51% of the workforce are female. 25% of Canadians are non-Caucasian. In the city of Toronto, that jumps over 50%. In cities like Markham, it gets up to 72%. People with disabilities has reached 1 in 5. Our birth rate is down to 1.6%. You know, I can throw out a lot of numbers, but what they add up to is that if your workforce is predominantly straight, white, able-bodied, and male, then you're missing out on a significant portion of the population.
Leadership has a role that we have the opportunity to create organizations that are free from barriers, create opportunity for people to really aspire to where they need to be, and to make all organizations successful. So it's on us.
We think in silos, especially in construction. It's very process driven. And the idea of taking different cultures and different people's ideas and knowledge sets and expanding the value of our brain trust is going to be critical in building the best new buildings for Canadians to use going forward.
For me, I see that the development of a diversity and inclusion strategy has to take place in the workplace to address the issue and also get coordinated visions from people to really make this work.
Most of us don't even realize we have biases until somebody else is speaking and somebody else is talking about the makeup of the CEOs in the province of Ontario as an example. And you see yourself on the screen as part of this white, middle-aged group of people, and you say, you know, we're as much a part of the problem as wanting to be part of the solution. So I think for me, it's just taking a little time to self-reflect.
We're bringing to the participants today a model we call the 6 C's of inclusive leadership. It's not ours. It's from Deloitte. But it really speaks to 6 things that make an inclusive leader.
If we looked at the 6 areas he proposed, is there one area we could start to say, I'm going to be a little braver, I'm going to be a little risky, and I'm going to actually force us to think about things like gender equality, but also sexual equality and what we're comfortable with accepting in the workplace? Because I think in health and safety, we're so safe and we're so risk averse that it's really a challenge for us to enter these conversations without feeling like we're opening a Pandora's box. And yet really, the Pandora's box is open and we just have to become more willing and able to have the conversations.
One of the 6 C's is courage, and it's one of, I think, the most important. And it's not courage as in run into a burning building. It's courage as in be willing to expose yourself, to be open and honest, to recognize your own biases, to recognize that you too are a flawed individual, and be willing to surround yourself with people who are different. I think courage is one of the most important things that an inclusive leader can have.